play Faye. She works in the supermarket, and she's sort of, which is in the middle of the buildings. So you don't really know where exactly she comes from, and I really liked that in her, because she's sort of the first one who starts to notice things go a little bit wrong, a little bit off, and she's kind of that person who's always there, but you don't even realise, because she's sort of the onlooker to the disaster that's developing. Then I don't want to say too much, because then I'm just giving the whole film away.
You spend a lot of your time on screen with the magnificent Tom Hiddleston. What was he like to work with, and what do you think makes him such an extraordinary talent?
He's fantastic. He is so dedicated and so kind as well. Sometimes you hear of actors and you think, oh, well, they're gonna be very like famous and all that blah. But no, with Tom, he was lovely and so supportive and fun and just normal, which is rare but good.
Ben is a unique director in so many ways. Can you talk a little bit about working with him behind the camera?
So funny. Very funny, very kind. He knows exactly what he wants and he's quite fantastic as well. I mean, he creates something with all the actors and then just sort of goes, okay, well, you're on the playground now. Off you go. The thing with High Rise, it's been a script that's been, that they've been trying to adapt for so long. And with this, what Amy and Ben have done is so great, in a sense that it takes the essence and the true tonalities of the book and takes it one step further. I mean, you know, any J.G. Ballard book is so dense and complex that you have to find that balance of what are you going to keep and what are the first feelings that you're going to take for that to then make your film. So I think people will really see that, because Ben, I think, is the perfect director for that story. His style and the way he does stories are just so attuned to J.G. Ballard's writing. So I think it's a win-win situation. I mean, it's about a lot of things. I think humanity and the possibility of evil existing within humans, which is terrifying. The social discord, I think is the word, that can occur so quickly, and how it can be entertained in a weird way. I think that's a big thing. I don't know if people are going to look at the film in that way, but I hope they do, because it's important to sort of look back and look at yourself. And even though it's period and it's based in the 70s, I think it's still so of our times. Am I making sense? I think I am.